Today's chemistry class. Today we will see sp3d, sp3d2 hybridization and resonance structures. So here, first of all, we discuss sp3d hybridization. So here sp3d hybridization is nothing but the intermixing of 1s orbitals, 3 1s orbital, 3p orbitals and 1d orbital, and after hybridization we get 5 hybrid orbitals, and they are directed to a trigonal bipyramidal structure, all these hybrid orbitals. Okay, so the intermixing of 1s, 3p and 1d orbitals. Okay, intermixing of 1s, 3p and 1d orbitals. And here we discuss only one example, PCl5. PCl5 is atomic number 15 and it has the electronic configuration. Okay, neon, 3s2, okay, 3p3, that is electronic configuration. So it has 5 electrons in its outermost shell. Okay, in its outermost shell, that is 3s2, 3p3, 3s2, 3p3. And there is no electron in 3d, 3p, 3, 3d, there is no electron. Okay, and other electrons are inner electrons. So PCl5, phosphorus has 3s2, 3p3, 3d, 0 in ground state. So in excited state, 3s1, 3p3 and 3d1. Okay, 3d1. So actually 5 orbitals are there for d orbitals. Okay, 3D1. And what is the hybridization here? It is sp3D hybridization. So here 1s orbital and 3p orbitals with 1d orbital. Okay, 1d orbital overlaps to form sp3D hybridization. Sp3D hybridization. Okay. So and here all the phosphorus, all the half-filled orbitals intermix to form sp3d hybridization, and we have 5 hybridized orbital, and these 5 hybridized orbital forms sigma bond with the chlorine atom, and you get 5 PCl sigma bonds, and the structure is like this. PCl sigma bond structure is like this, trigonal bipyramidal. Trigonal bipyramidal. The structure name is trigonal bipyramidal with bond angle 120 degree. 3 bond angles are 120 degree and 2 bond angles are 90 degree. So 120 and this also 120, and these two are 90 degree. Okay. So 3 bond angles are 120 degree and 2 bond angles are 90 degree. Such a trigonal bipyramidal. So this is due to the repulsion of bond pairs, the structure is like this. Okay, and that is all about sp3d hybridization. Now we can discuss sp3d2 hybridization. Here we have sp3d2 hybridization. Okay, what is sp3d2 hybridization? We can discuss that. Okay, we can discuss sp3d2 hybridization. And in sp3d2 hybridization, it is intermixing of 1s, 3p and 3d orbitals. So here sp3d2 means intermixing of 1s, 3p and 2d orbitals. Sorry, 2d, not 3d, 2d orbitals. Okay, 1s, 3p and 2d orbitals intermixed to form 5 plus 1 more is there, 6 hybridized orbitals. 6 hybrid orbitals are there. 6 6 hybrid orbitals. Okay, so 1s, 3p and 2d orbitals intermixed to form 6 hybrid orbitals. Okay, and here we have the structure, octahedral structure. The structure is octahedral. Bond angle 90 degree always, and all the bond angles are 90 degree. Example sulfur. Okay, hexafluoride. Example is sulfur hexafluoride SF6. So sulfur atomic number, you know that is, it is 16. Okay, atomic number. And electronic ground state electronic configuration is 3s2 4. Okay, 3s2 3p4, and there is no electron in 3d orbitals. Okay, it is 6 electrons in outermost. Okay, 6 electrons in outermost. Okay, 6 electrons are there altogether, and there is no electrons in d orbital. So 3s 3p and 3d. And here in x, this is ground state electronic configuration, and in excited state it has 3s 1 3p 3 and 3d and 3d 2. That means one electron from 3s is excited 3d, and one electron from 3p is excited to another 3d. So 1s, 3p and 2d orbitals overlap to form sp3d2 hybridization. sp3d2 hybridization. Okay, sp3d2 hybridization. So here sulfur forms 6 sigma bonds with the fluorine. 6 sigma bonds with the fluorine, and 4 the bonds are in the same plane, and 1 bond is above the plane, another bond is below the plane, and all the bond angles are 90 degree. All the bond angles are 90 degree. With the structure, it is octahedral structure. Structure name is octahedral. So this is an exception to the octet rule, because after bonding, sulfur gets 12 electrons. After bonding, sulfur gets 12 electrons. Okay, that is all about sp3d2 hybridization. Structure octahedral, 6 hybrid orbitals, bond angle 90 degree. Okay, so the topic hybridization is over. Now we will discuss resonance structures. Resonance. We can discuss resonance structures. So resonance, I think you have already seen what is resonance structure. Okay. Resonance. Okay, for some compounds it is not possible to give a particular structure for one compound, or all the properties of a compound cannot be explained by using a single structure. So we need more than one structure for a particular compound, and such structures are known as resonance structure. சில கோம்பௌண்டுகளுக்கு ஒரு ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் கொண்டு തന്നെ அதை ரெப்ரசென்ட் ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റാതെ வரும். ഒന്നിൽ കൂടുതൽ സ്ട്രക്ചർ ഉപയോഗിക്കേണ്ടി വരും അതിനെ റെപ്രസെന്റ് ചെയ്യാൻ. അല്ലെങ്കിൽ അതിന്റെ എല്ലാ പ്രോപ്പർട്ടിയും നമ്മൾ എക്സ്പ്ലെയിൻ ചെയ്യാൻ ഒന്നിൽ കൂടുതൽ സ്ട്രക്ചർ പറ്റുള്ളൂ. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് നോൺ ആസ് റെസൊണൻസ് സ്ട്രക്ചർ. ആൻഡ് ദ ആക്ച്വൽ സ്ട്രക്ചർ ഓഫ് ദാറ്റ് പർട്ടിക്കുലർ മോളിക്യൂൾ ഓർ പർട്ടിക്കുലർ കോമ്പൗണ്ട് ലൈസ് സംവെയർ ഇൻ ബിറ്റ്വീൻ ദീസ് ഓൾ സ്ട്രക്ചേഴ്സ്. സോ ഫസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ഓൾ വി ക്യാൻ ടേക്ക് ദ എക്സാമ്പിൾ ഓഫ് ഓസോൺ. Ozone, molecular formula O3, ozone O3. Okay, the structure is like this: O double bond or single bond. This is the first structure of ozone. Okay, first structure of ozone. And the second structure is like this: O single bond or double bond. Okay, that means this double bond is shifted to this position. And each structure is known as canonical structure. Each structure is known as canonical structure. Each structure is known as canonical structure. And in between two structures we use a double headed arrow. Here we have double headed arrow. In between two structures. Okay, and we need these two structures. This is the second structure. We need these two structures to explain the all properties. Explain all the properties of ozone. Okay, O3 molecule. Okay, and so all the properties of ozone can be explained by using these two structures, and the exact structure lies somewhere in between these two, or we can say the average of these two structure. That is a essence of the resonance structure. And not only ozone, we can use many compounds. We can take many compounds as example for the resonance structure. Second one, we can take benzene. Okay, benzene. The structure of benzene is discovered by Kekulé. Okay, so benzene is like this structure. Okay, like this. One structure is like this. So another structure is this one. Alternative double and single bond. So this can also be possible. That means this is shifted to this position and it in order and this one in order. So we will get a alternate double and single bond structure. Second, this is first, this is second structure, and third structure. And in some theory portion of this resonance structure, you can see this structure of benzene. The third bond is like this. Okay, in between, just half symmetrically drawn. Okay, that is third structure, and it is equivalent to the structure like this. So we represent this a circle to represent the double bond or the delocalization of double bond is like this. So it is equivalent to this structure. So we can also use this structure, but the actual structure of benzene lies in between these, lies somewhere in between these three structures. Okay, the actual structure lies somewhere in between these three structures. So we need all these three structures or all the different structures to explain the all properties, especially the chemical properties of benzene. Chemical properties of benzene. And also we can take another example. Okay, carbon dioxide. Resonance structure of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is a linear molecule. Carbon dioxide. It is CO2. Carbon dioxide is a linear molecule. CO2. This is our structure. Actually, we use this one structure. And one possibility is there. This is another structure of carbon dioxide. And this one is another structure of carbon dioxide. Now, here this bond is shifted. This one bond will be here. And three bonds will be there. This is the average structure, we can say, or for purpose of for the reactions, or generally we take this structure for carbon dioxide. And these three are the resonance structures of carbon dioxide. And the actual structure lies somewhere between these three. And all the properties can be explained by using all these three structures. So resonance structure is nothing but, in some cases, some compound cannot be explained, or some compound cannot be designated by only one structure. We need more structures to explain the properties of this compound. So we use resonance structures, and the actual structure of the molecule lies somewhere between these structures. Okay, and that is all about today's class. Thank you.